start by saying I think in any democratic process, justice should be seen to be done. And I've got to say, I've held this comment since the last meeting. Standards and Ethics Committee is a pretty weighty name for a committee that really does very little, even to the extent of being unwilling to name anybody. I mean, I refer back to our last meeting and the Biko case. You know, the kids in the schoolyard are shouting out the names of the people who were involved in Biko, and yet we were not allowed to mention any names. We were told that three had gone to five, but no names would be mentioned. And in any of the standards and ethics committees I've sat on now for the last couple of years, nobody's been ever named for anything. And here we are being asked once again not to name the person who is widely known to be the subject of the complaint. My feeling is justice should be seen to be done. So let it be seen to be done.
Some of what you're saying is particularly relevant to this particular issue, but we are quite prepared to have a meeting in public. Should we decide to tie it to us, whether it is held in public or not?
Councillor Simon, would you like to make a
comment? I think there's a couple of issues, isn't there? I wouldn't disagree in the sentiments of Councillor Lake in general, but I suppose in respect of all. It's like they're doing disciplinary of somebody as well, isn't it? You know, as I do a member of staff, you know, there are certain parameters of that, you know, maybe in the public domain and other bits that may not, if there's no case to find and, you know, etc. So I think, you know, I would agree with yourself, Peter, it's a fine balancing act. I mean, clearly, all of the members of the committee know the names of the people involved, both officers, the claimants, you know, etc. and any officers involved, because we've had all of those papers in advance of the meeting to read. So I suppose it's, you know, I'm just thinking of other committees that have sat on, particularly appointments and disciplinary, where you have certain deadlines. This is a very new committee, and this is the first time we've heard a specific case where a complaint has been made and then it's been brought to us. So I think it's you know, I mean, obviously we've read what's in the report, so it depends how that goes. So I think it is a balance that they agree that, you know, justice needs to be seen to be done in a fair process. There also needs to be a fair process to anyone who's complained about as well.
And, you know, to respond to that, Wendy, can I just add an addendum to my comments? Yes, justice should be seen to be done, but not necessarily if someone's going to get hurt in that process.
Sure.
You know, so and I would be sensitive to that.
Yes, through you, Chair, just to really remind you that the public interest test is in front of you, really. So the obligation is to release information unless in all the circumstances of the case the public interest in maintaining the exemption, which we've applied to this report, we've had that exempted under paragraphs 1 and 2. So if maintaining the exemption outweighs the public interest in disclosing information, that's the balance that's in front of you at the moment. So you've got to make a judgment about that public interest, and where the balance between disclosure and withholding the information is seen as equal, then there's an argument that you should release that information. I mean, I can go through examples of where it'd be in favour of in the public interest to disclose, but what I would say in response to the Councillor's point earlier is that if there is a finding of a breach, then obviously that decision is made public, and then obviously, you know, we give a reason at that point in time as well.
I suppose for some of my comments is if you call to aid exempt, it's really difficult than having a public meeting to discuss the report. You know, in that sense, I'm not saying it shouldn't be in public, but how, if the report is exempt and information in relation to that report, how do we discuss it? I know we will have a private session anyway, as you always do when you come.
privilege to state it. And I think by not having a meeting in public flies against everything that she said to date.
Private.